Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Grade Up. The moment you get my voice, please write, yes, sir, you are audible and visible in the comment section so that I could start my class. So, guys, am I audible? मेरी आवाज आ रही है आप लोगों को? Good morning, Manas. Good morning, everyone. Okay, so I think I'm audible. I have verified by myself. So welcome to Grade Up. This is Salik, and I hope you are aware that daily at 11 a.m. I come up with the daily current affairs. So today at 11 a.m. that is on Tuesday, we'll be having a daily current affairs and a static portion, of course. So we will be covering the static portion in the second half, and the first half we'll be covering the daily current affairs. So welcome to Grade Up. Good morning, Saswat, Manas. Good morning, everyone. So let's start the class. The question number one. Let's start with the question number one. The question number one says, NABARD has sanctioned Rs. 388 crore under Rural Infrastructure Development Fund for 4 drinking water and 20 rural road projects in which states? Your options are Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Telangana. NABARD stands for National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. Its job is to provide loans, finances to rural areas and agriculture. Okay, so NABARD has given 388 crore, to Rural Infrastructure Development Fund for 4 drinking water and 20 rural road projects in which states? And these are your options. Good morning, Shifa, Saswat, Manas. Yes, the right answer to this question is C. Odisha is the right answer to this question. So Yash and Vandana are right. So in Malkangiri district, you can say Koraput district and Balasore district, this RIDF assistance scheme will be implemented. Okay, so the answer to this question is actually C. Odisha is the right answer. Right, so Shifa is also right. C is the right answer. Shifa, Vandana and Yash, you all are right. Let's move on further to the next question, the question number two. So the question number two says, the Reserve Bank of India has imposed a penalty of Rs. 25 lakh on which PSU bank for non-compliance with certain provisions of directions on cyber security framework in banks. And these are your options, Bank of India, Punjab and Sindh Bank, Indian Bank, Bank of Maharashtra, or Canara Bank. These are your options. Okay, so Saswat is saying I am from Odisha. Very good. Okay, so you have to tell me that Reserve Bank of India has imposed a fine or penalty, whatever you can say, of 25 lakh on PSU bank. So public sector bank are those bank which have at least 51% share with the government, right? So majority share is with the government, that is called as PSU or public sector bank, sometimes called as PSB, public sector bank. Okay, so a fine has been imposed, and the right answer to this question is very good. Yash, Vandana, Shifa, Apit, Ayan, you all are right. B is the right answer to this question. So you can see it here, RBI imposes Rs. 25 lakh penalty on Punjab and Sindh Bank. So this is the logo of Punjab and Sindh Bank. It is written a Government of India undertaking. It means the majority share is with the Government of India. Okay, so just remember it, guys. Yes, let's move on further to the next one. You can see it here. This is for non-compliance of this cyber security framework in basics. So they were not following these rules, because of which they have been imposed fine. Okay. Okay. Yes. Let's move on further to the next question. That is question number three. So the question number three says, who has authored the book titled Nathuram Godse, The True Story of Gandhi's Assassin? And these are options. Dhaval Kulkarni, Sushant Singh, Shruti Rao, Samar Harlankar, Bobby Ghosh. These are your options. Kisne ye kitab likhi hai? Nathuram Godse, the true story of Gandhi's assassin. And these are your options. Dhaval Kulkarni, Sushant Singh, Shruti Rao, Samar Harlankar, Bobby Ghosh. And yes, I have got the right answer from Yash, Abhid Bhatnagar, Manas. You all are right. A is the right answer to this question. Yes, Vandana, you all are right. You can see it here. Nathuram Godse, the true story of Gandhi's assassin, written by Dhaval Kulkarni. So just remember it. It will be launched in 2022. Okay. Yes, Vandana, Shifa, you all are right. A is the right answer to this question. Okay. Let's move on further to the next question. the question number 4. The question number 4 says, who has authored the children's book titled India to the Rescue? And these are your options: Shruti Rao, Sushant Singh, Dhaval Kulkarni, Samar Harlankar, both A and B. Kisne ye kitab likhi hai, children's book India to the Rescue? And these are your options: Shruti Rao, Sushant Singh, Dhaval Kulkarni, Samar Harlankar, both A and B. Okay guys, answer this question. And guys, everyone, please like the session. Everyone, yes, the right answer, I think nobody is answering me this question. So the right answer to this question is actually E, both A and B is the right answer to this question. Both Shruti Rao and Sushant Singh has written this question, and Vandana is right. Very good, Vandana. You can see it here, Manas, Shifa, you all are right. Sushant Singh with Shruti Rao, they have written a book, India to the Rescue, and this is about a mission to Maldives. Operation Cactus was a mission which was supported by India in 1988. So it was to solve the Maldives crisis. Okay, just go and read little bit about Operation Cactus. Vandana, Manas, Shifa, Yes, Manas, Shiramkar, you all are right. E is the right answer to this. Manasi, Shiramkar, you all are right. E is the right answer to this question. Okay, let's move on further to the next question, the question number 5, which says, who has won Austrian Grand Prix 2021? Your options are Max Verstappen, Valtteri Bottas, Lewis Hamilton, Lando Norris, Daniel Ricciardo. These are your options. You have to tell me the Austrian Grand Prix kisne jeeta hai. And these are options, and the image, the hint is the image. If you recognize him, that's fine. Okay, and yes, Yash Sharma is right. Of course, A, Max Verstappen is the right answer to this question. Yash, Arpit, Shifa, Saswat, Vandana, you all are right. Now, Max Verstappen is performing very well, of course. So, in 70-80% of the cases, Max Verstappen will be the right answer. Right, yes, third in a row, right, Yash. So, yes, Vandana, Manasi, Saswat, Shifa, Arpit, Manas, you all are right. Max Verstappen has won Austrian Grand Prix. So we call it as Grand Prix. Prix nahi padte hain, Prix padte hain. And he's of course from Red Bull. So this is a third victory in a row. Inhe teen lagatar victory kiya inhone. So just remember it. If you will find some Grand Prix related questions, 70-80% chance you can mark this one. Even if you don't remember, you can try Max Verstappen, then 70-80% chances are there. It will be okay, right? Okay. Because sab yaad rakhna thoda mushkil hai, so you can remember like this. Okay, Manas, Ayan, you all are right. A is the right answer to this question. Okay, let's move on to next question, the question number 6, which says, the central government has a fund for setting up a vaccine testing laboratory in National Institute of Animal Biotechnology. In which city? Chennai, Ahmedabad, Hyderabad, Bangalore, New Delhi. Yes, practice makes perfect. Okay, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने एक फंड बनाया है फॉर सेटिंग अप वैक्सीन टेस्टिंग लैबोरेटरी इन नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एनिमल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इन चेन्नई, अहमदाबाद, हैदराबाद, बेंगलुरु, न्यू दिल्ली. ओके, यस, द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑफकोर्स सी, हैदराबाद इज द राइट आंसर. एंड यश, अर्पित, सस्वत, मानसी, वंदना, मानस, शिफा, यू ऑल आर राइट. यूनियन गवर्नमेंट हैज सैंक्शन एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ न्यू वैक्सीन टेस्टिंग लैबोरेटरी इन हैदराबाद बाय पीएम केयर्स फंड. Okay, and it will be set up at National Institute of Animal Biotechnology in Hyderabad and will be under, of course, Department of Biotechnology. Just remember it, okay? Okay, yes, Ayan, yes, you're right. Okay, let's move on further to the next one. That is the question number 7. Guys, everyone, please like the session. Everyone, I am seeing only 9 likes, 13 are watching. So guys, everyone, like the session, share with the people and subscribe to the channel. Everyone, please press the subscribe button also. The question number 7 says, who has won FIDEchess.com Women's Speed Chess Championship 2021? Your options are Huo Yufan, Arika Dronavali, Alexander Goryachkina, Wenjung Zhu, Katerina Jagno, Katerina Lagno. These are your options. And I think, yes, right, A is the right answer to this question. People have answered me. Very good. Yash, Arpit, Manasi, Manas, you all are right. Vandana, you all are right. You can see it here. Grandmaster Huo Yufan of China won the FIDEchess.com Women's Speed Chess Championship. Okay. And of course, you can see it here. Harika has got a second rank, of course, because she has been defeated. You can see it here. Hyderabad ki Harika. Okay. So she has got rank. second with $12,000. Okay, yes, Manas, Manasi, Vandana, Shifa, Payal, you all are right. A is the right answer to this question. Okay, let's move on to the next question. That is question number 8. Levon Aronian has won the Gold Money Asian Rapid Online Chess title. He is from which country? Your options are Russia, Hungary, Armenia, Ukraine, Poland. You have to tell me that Levon Aronian has won Gold Money Asian Rapid Online Chess title. He is from which country? Kis country se belong karte hai, ye aapko batana hai. These are your options: Russia, Hungary, Armenia, Ukraine, Poland. So the right answer to this question is of course C. Yashama, Arpit, Manasi, you all are right. So you can see it here: Gold Money Asian Rapid Online Chess, Aronian blanks Armitiv wins title. So he is from of course Armenia, Armenian Grandmaster. Okay, so just remember it. Yes, Yash, Arpit, Manasi, Vandana, Payal, Manas, you all are right. C is the right answer. Okay, he will receive $30,000 prize for winning first prize. Okay, let's move on further to the next one, the question number 8. The question number 8 says, according to provisional statistics of 2020-2021 released by Coal Ministry in fiscal year 2020-2021, which state registered highest coal production? Your options are Jharkhand, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, West Bengal. आपको ये बताना है कि प्रोविजनल स्टैटिस्टिक्स जो 2020-21 की आई है, जो कि कोल मिनिस्ट्री ने रिलीज किया है, विच स्टेट इन दिस ईयर, दिस फिस्कल ईयर, एफ आई मीन्स फिस्कल ईयर विच स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1 अप्रैल 2020 टू 31 मार्च 2021, राइट, विच स्टेट हैज रजिस्टर्ड हाइएस्ट कोल प्रोडक्शन, एंड दीज आर योर ऑप्शंस, एंड द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी गुड. यश, वंदना, शिफा, मानस, अर्पित, यू ऑल आर राइट. डी, छत्तीसगढ़ इज द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. So just remember it, according to the data released, India's total coal production was saw a marginal in a slight decline as compared to the during the last fiscal, and of course Chhattisgarh registered the highest coal production. Okay, so yes, Arpit, yes, Manas, you all are right. D is the right answer to this question. Okay, let's move on further to question number 9. So the question number 9 says, who has been named the flag bearer of Indian contingent in the Tokyo Paralympics 2021, and these are your options: Mariappan Thangavelu, Devendra Jhajharia, Ajit Singh, Ekta Bhayan, Kashish Lakra. These are your options. Who has been named as flag bearer? Jo jhanda leke chalte, that's flag bearer, right? In the Tokyo Paralympics. See, I hope you are aware that Tokyo Olympics and Tokyo Paralympics both were supposed to happen in 2020, but because of COVID-19, now it will be happening this year, right? So Paralympic means the Olympics for the physically disabled, right? So you have to tell me. Yes, current affairs, kisi bhi current affairs exam ke liye ye question important, these questions, right? Yes, Shifa. Okay, the right answer to this question is A. Yash, Saswat, Shifa, Vandana, Arpit, you all are right. Mariappan Thangavelu is the right answer to this question. You can see it here. This is the guy. ठीक है, तो आप इसलिए मैंने ऐसे झंडा दिखा दिया ताकि ये वाली फोटो ताकि आपको याद रहे कि Mariappan Thangavelu named India's flag bearer for Tokyo Paralympics. So just remember it. Okay. It is said that Tokyo Paralympics will start from 24th August this year. So just remember it. Okay. Let's move on further to the next question. That is question number 10. So the question number 10 says, who took charge as the new managing director of National High Speed Rail Corporation of India Limited? Your options are K.N. Bhattacharya, Shambhunath Srivastav, Satish Agnihotri, Praveen Sinha, Mukesh Sharma. Kisne naya, kon naye managing director bane hain National High Speed Rail Corporation Limited ke? K.N. Bhattacharya, Shambhunath Srivastav, Satish Agnihotri, Praveen Sinha, Mukesh Sharma. These are your options. And of course, the right answer to this question is C. Satish Agnihotri is the right answer to this question. Yes. Yes, Sharma, Apit Bhatnagar, Vandana, you all are right. C is the right answer to this question. So he is a former IRSE officer and he has been appointed as the new managing director of National High Speed Rail Corporation Limited. Yes, yes, Apit, Vandana, Ayan, you all are right. C is the right answer to this question. Payal, Abhi Sayo, you all are right. Now, let's move on to question number 11, which says, which bank has launched Salaam Dil Se initiative to pay tribute and show gratitude to the doctors across the country for their tireless service during the pandemic at the risk of their own lives. Your options are ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, Yes Bank, Axis Bank, या Indus Ind Bank. सो किस बैंक ने सलाम दिल से इनिशिएटिव लाया है ताकि थैंक्स गिविंग या ग्रेटिट्यूड पे कर सके डॉक्टर्स को जिन्होंने काफ़ी पैंडेमिक में टायरलेसली वर्क किया अपनी जान को रिस्क पर रखकर. एंड दीज आर ऑप्शन ICICI बैंक, HDFC बैंक, येस बैंक, एक्सिस बैंक, इंडस इंड बैंक. एंड यस ऑफ कोर्स द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज राइट, HDFC बैंक बी इज द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. सो यश, शिफा, वंदना, you all are right. B is the right answer to this question. You can see it here. HDFC presents Salaam Dil Se. Okay. So in fact, they have come up with the website www.salaamdilse.com. Okay. So just remember it. Yes. So B is the right answer to this question. Now let's move on to the next one. The question number 12, which says, which project has been launched by Ministry of Education to create an enabling environment to ensure universal acquisition of foundational literacy and numeracy so that every child achieves the desired learning competency by 2026-2027. Your options are Safal Bharat, Nipun Bharat, Sadgun Bharat, Samat Bharat, or Kaushal Bharat. Which project has been launched by Ministry of Education? Kaun si project Ministry of Education abhi launched ki hai recently? ताकि टू इंश्योर कि यूनिवर्सल हर को एक्विजिशन ऑफ फाउंडेशनल लिटरेसी एंड न्यूमरेसी के लिए बेसिक नॉलेज सबको मिल जाए एंड दैट बाय 2026-2027. एंड दिस हैपेंड वेरी रिसेंटली एंड वेरी गुड. द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज बी. यश, हरपित, शिफा, अर्पित, वंदना, विवेक, यू ऑल आर राइट. बी इज द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. यू कैन सी इट हियर. दिस इज the tweet by Minister of State for Education. You can see it here. NIPUN. This stands for National Initiative for Proficiency in Reading with Understanding and Numeracy. So just remember it. Of course, it is from Ministry of Education. Take care. NIPUN Bharat Scheme. So this is yesterday's 5th July, 12 p.m. Okay? Yes. Let's move on further to the next one. Isi baare mein aap thoda detail mein padh lena. Take care. To the next question, that is question number 13. So the question number 13 says, which bank has launched Salute Doctors, a comprehensive banking solution for doctors? Your options are ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, Yes Bank, Axis Bank, IndusInd Bank. Kis bank ne ye launch kiya hai Salute Doctors, a comprehensive banking solution for doctors? And these are options ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, Yes Bank, Axis Bank, IndusInd Bank. So Salute Doctor scheme has been launched by Yes, of course. Very good. Yash, Arpit, you are performing very well. Shifa, Ayan, you are all right. ICICI Bank is the right answer to this question. Ayan, Vandana, you are all right. So ICICI Bank has announced launch of comprehensive banking solution for doctors titled as Salute Doctors. Right, Ayan, Vandana, Sumit, Shifa, you are all right. A is the right answer to this question. Sumit, Payal, aap log sab sahi ho. Very good. You all are performing very well. Well done. Let's move on to the next one. That is question number 14. So the question number 14 says, renowned sportsman M. Prasannan passed away recently. He was associated with which sports? Your options are cricket, chess, football, hockey, basketball. These are your options. Yes, Vivek, Payal, Sumit, you all were right. ICICI was the right answer to the question number 13. Now tell me the question number 14. Renowned sportsman M. Prasannan passed away recently. He was associated with which sports? And of course, the right answer to this question is C. Football is the right answer to this question. So yes, Yash, Arpit, Shifa, Vivek, you all are right. C is the right answer to this question. He played for Kerala, Maharashtra, Goa, etc. And his name was M. Prasannan. He died at the age of 73 in Mumbai. Okay. So yes, Shifa, Vivek, Sumit, Ayan, Vandana, you all are right. C is the right answer to this question. Okay, Sumit, Vandana, Payal, you all are right. Okay. Let's move on to the next one. That is question number 15. Recently, this has been announced that world's third largest cricket stadium will be built in which city in India? Your options are Jaipur, New Delhi, Bengaluru, Kolkata, Hyderabad. World's third largest cricket stadium will come up in which city? Jaipur, New Delhi, Bengaluru, Kolkata, Hyderabad. These are your options. And I think it's very easy. If you have read it yesterday's newspaper, you can answer it. News, any news. Yes, right. So yes, Shifa, Vandana, you all are right. Jaipur is the right answer to this question. Vandana, Arpit, you all are right. You can see it here. World's third largest cricket stadium to come up in Jaipur. Okay. And it has been announced by Rajasthan Cricket Academy because, of course, Jaipur is in, of course, Rajasthan. Okay. It will be constructed between on Jaipur-Delhi highway near it. Yes, Arpit, Sumit, Vivek, you all are right. A is the right answer to this question. The two largest are, of course, Narendra Modi Stadium, Motera, and the second one is Melbourne Cricket Stadium in Australia. So most likely this will be the third one. 75,000 spectators ki capacity hogi and all that. Payal, Vivek, you all are right. A is the right answer to this question. Guys, please like the session, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel. Everyone, please like the session, everyone. Okay. Let's move on further to the next one. Now, we will be discussing some static portion. Okay? Kuch static portion, 4-5 questions. The second half, I have told you that it will be the static portion. Now, answer me. This is a very famous one. Hiroshima Day is, I should not write celebrated. Hiroshima Day is on which date? 6th August, 6th July, 6th September, 6th December. See, what happened was in 1945, the USA dropped atom bomb on a Japanese city, Hiroshima actually. Okay. So actually it dropped on two cities, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, but we are talking about Hiroshima, and the right answer is, of course, 6th August 1945, dropped bomb in Hiroshima, and on 9th August, it dropped bomb on Nagasaki. Okay, so yes, Hiroshima Day is on 6th August. So yes, Vivek, Payal, Shifa, Saswat, you all are right. 6th August is the right answer to this question. So of course, 6th August ko and Nagasaki 9th August and 6th August ko Hiroshima, right? So yes, Sharma, Saswat, you all are right. Shifa, A is the right answer to this question. Yes, Arpit, you are also right. Let's move on to question number 2, which says, in which year did Afghanistan join SAARC? I have told you that SAARC is an 8-member body, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. It is an 8-member body, 8-member, you can say, grouping, comprising of South Asian nations. You have to tell me that Afghanistan joined in which year. These are your options: 2007 2008 2005 or 2006. Yes, Saswat, you are right. They actually observed this 6 August ko Hiroshima Day. Observed likhna zyada behtar hai, celebrated sahi word nahi hai, right, Saswat? Of course. So yes, in 1945, Payal wala, yes, right. Answer the question number 2, which says, in which year Afghanistan joined SAARC? So these are your options, and the right answer to this question is, of course, 2007 is the right answer to this question. Afghanistan joined SAARC as 8th member. So SAARC stands for South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. It comprises of Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka. I have taught you in various batches, in fact, in the app classes also. So yes, so A is the right answer. So Shifa is right. A is the right answer to this question. So just remember it. And yes, the headquarter of SAARC or the secretariat is in Kathmandu, the capital city of Nepal. It was founded in 1985. Right, Arpit is also right. Shifa is right. 2007 is the right answer to this question. Okay, let's move on further to question number 3, which says, the Sahitya Academy Award was instituted in the year 1992, 1989, 1960, 1954. These are your options. Sahitya Academy Award kis saal se start kiya gaya? And these are your options, guys. Yes, guys, everyone, join the Telegram link. Click on the link and join the Telegram so that whenever we'll be putting a new video, you will get the notification. Okay, join the Telegram group. Okay, the link is given in the live chat. Yes, Vandana, you will get to know jab start hoga, so you'll get to know. Classes on, you can say app. Okay, so the right answer to this question is D, of course, 1954. Sahitya Academy Award was instituted in the year 1954. Okay, it was the second highest literary award by Indian government. The first is called as, of course, Janan Peeth Award, is the first highest literary award. The second one is Sahitya Academy Award. Okay, so D, 1954 is the right answer to this question. Let's move on to question number 4. The question number 4 says, which of the following places is not associated with Kumbh Mela? Your options are Nasik, Ujjain, Haridwar, Puri. दीज आर ऑप्शंस. आपको ये बताना है कि कुंभ मेला से कौन से सिटी एसोसिएटेड नहीं. आई थिंक इट्स वेरी इजी टू आंसर इट. यस यश, थ्री का डी था, दैट यू वर राइट, यश एंड विवेक. नाउ आंसर द क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर. द क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर सेज, the question number 4 says which of the following places is not associated with Kumbh Mela. These are your options: Nasik, Ujjain, Haridwar, Puri. I think it's very easy. Instead of Puri it should be Prayagraj or Allahabad, right? So yes, D is the right answer. So Yash, Ayan, Vandana, you all are right. D is the right answer to this question. Kumbh Mela is on Allahabad, that is Prayagraj, then Haridwar, Nasik and Ujjain. So these are the important rivers. Ujjain is on Shipra River. Of course, Allahabad is on Ganga, Yamuna, confluence. And Nasik is on Godavari River. Haridwar is on Ganga River. Okay? So just remember it. Yes, Ayan, Vandana, Arpit, you are right. D is the right answer to this question. Now the question number 5 says, the Jallianwala Bagh massacre has recently completed 102 years. When was the Rowlatt Act passed which authorized the government to imprison or confined without a trial any person associated with it? See, what happened was a Rowlatt Act was passed. So in this act, it was mentioned that if you are protesting against the government, they can put you in jail for 2 years without trial. Yani koi court mein case wagara nahi chalega. So due to that, people started protesting and two famous person called as Saifuddin Kichliu and Satyapal, both were arrested. So in order to protest their arrest, there was a peace program that was organized in Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar. Jallianwala Bagh is a small park. And what happened was on 13th April actually, General Dyer with his military entered and opened fire and killed many people. So you have to tell me that when was this Rowlatt Act passed? So of course this was passed just before this, because this incident happened in 13th April 1919. So iska to koi scope nahi hai, right? So just before this, a bhi nahi ho sakta, because 13th April 1919 se just pehle. So the right answer is of course 10th March 1919 is the right answer to this question. Rowlatt Act was passed on 20th March 1919. Then people protested, got arrested, and then people were doing a peace march, a peace request or protest, whatever you can say, in Jallianwala Bagh. And when police came and opened the fire. आपने अवार्ड्स पढ़ाए? हाँ पढ़ाता हूँ, जो जो चीज़ करंट अफेयर्स में आ रहा है सब कवर कराता हूँ. ओके ओके राइट, यस. सो ए इज द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, व्हिच सेज ही वाज द फॉर्मर प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया, इलेक्टेड टू द पोस्ट ऑफ वाइस चांसलर अलीगढ़ मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी 1948 एंड टू द एग्जीक्यूटिव बोर्ड ऑफ यूनेस्को. ही ट्रांसलेटेड प्लेटोस बुक रिपब्लिक एंड एडविन कैनन्स एलिमेंट्री पॉलिटिकल इकोनॉमी. ही वॉज वॉट? These are options: Rajendra Prasad, Zakir Hussain, Sanjeevan Reddy, APJ Abdul Kalam. You have to answer it, guys. I think it's very easy. You can apply the logic. He became the Vice Chancellor in 1948. So, APJ Abdul Kalam, no chance, because APJ Abdul Kalam was, child at the time of 1948. So they are very less likelihood. Now Rajendra Prasad, Zakir Hussain, Sanjeevan Reddy. Understand your logic. Aligarh Muslim University, it means someone would be a Muslim. So you can guess in the exam also, right? This a guess will work. This is how to approach in the exam and answer the question correctly even if you don't know. Is tarah se try karna elimination process hai. And that will be very beneficial. This is how I am teaching you to eliminate the options. So of course the right answer is B, Zakir Hussain. He got Bharat Ratna in 1963, translated Plato's book in Urdu. And yes, he was first Muslim president of India. Of course, he was Vice Chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University, of course. So the B is the right answer to this question. So yes, Yash Sharma is the right answer to this question. The question number 7 says, which is the largest library in India? This is the image. Khudabaksh Oriental Library, Sinha Library, State Central Library, National Library of India. These are your options. And I think it's very easy to answer it. The largest library in India is National Library of India, Kolkata. Okay, just remember it. So it is the largest library of India in Calcutta. And of course, it was a place of Governor General of India. It was the official residence. So when before 1911, Calcutta was the capital city of India. Okay, so and this was once the residence of Governor General of India at that time. Okay, so National Library of India is the largest library in Calcutta. Yes, so yes, Ayan is right. D is the right answer to this question. The last one is, in which year India successfully conducted India's first nuclear site? 1966, 64, 76, 74. So of course the right answer to this question is 1974. The first test happened during the time of Indira Gandhi. So D is the right answer to this question. So first nuclear test happened in Rajasthan's Pokhran in 1974 and the code name was Smiling Buddha. So D is the right answer to this question, right? So D is the right. Yes, Yash, Ayan, Payal, you all were right. जिन्होंने भी D answer किया था, आप लोग सही हो. Okay. Okay. Yes. Yes. So this was about today's class. These are our batches for YouTube sessions. So you do join it, whatever you like. Take the screenshot. And yes, we are having IFT interview experience, 99.8 percentile in IFT, 10 July 9 p.m. with Mr. Ayush Dubey. And with Anadi Chaturvedi, I am Rohtak student, setting up right target for IIMs from 11th July at 7:30 p.m. on GradeUp app. Join us on app, and here this will be on YouTube, 10th July 9 p.m. on YouTube. Okay, these are our MACT MBA crash course. Yes, Payal, Kolkata is the new word, Calcutta is the old name. Okay, so yes, guys, we are providing a flat 50% off on all our GradeUp Super courses. You have to use the code UNLOCK50 to get 50% off on all GradeUp Super courses for CAT, MACT, CMAT and other MBA entrance examination. So these are our batches which have started from June 2021. You can see it, take the screenshot. If you have any query, call on this number. These are our batches, weekend batch, weekdays batch, comprehensive course batch, retakers, rankers batch, MHCT batch, SNAP and MAT testnet 2022 batches. Okay, these are experts, take the screenshot and mention it. Okay, so these are super subscription plan for 31st March 2022, for 31st March 2023, interactive course and 90 plus mocks, doubt solving sessions, regular quizzes, etc, etc. Okay, just take the screenshot. We are providing a free internet. If there is a 6 months course, we are providing 6 months free internet, 12 months course, 12 months free internet, 24 months course, 24 months free internet. This was all about today's class. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, Telegram, join us, download the GradeUp app. Thank you everyone and like the session. Thank you.